Greetings, my movie ghouls. Welcome to another episode of Halloween Countdown. 31 films in 31 days. Tonight, we watched Scream 2. And it's been a long time since I've watched this film. And it's quite surprising how Scary Movie copied it. And I know it's supposed to be like a parody of it, but a lot of it is just like copy and pasted, isn't it? Like, we were talking about how clumsy Ghostface is. It can't stand up. You said that I could do it. And it's a bit silly.
It's almost, and apart from the psychotic side, oh, yeah. He's so really clumsy, you would have been made for that.
I know. Well, he falls over at every moment. And she does actually throw a bike down some stairs.
Yeah, I didn't realise that was in the actual film.
I know.
I just thought it was in the Scary Movie one.
But other than that Scream, the whole series of Scream, just being commentary on slasher movies, it's great. I really enjoyed them. I prefer the first one. The second one, I don't really know as much. Third, fourth, I don't think I've seen. I might have seen the third one. But they're quite entertaining films. What do you think?
I like Scream movies. I think I've only seen this twice.
Yeah.
I quite enjoy them. They're quite tongue-in-cheek, and that's what I like. Yeah. They don't take themselves too seriously. They're all very similar age to me, actually, I'd say. Forgot Buffy the Vampire Slayer. She gets killed off fairly early.
She does, yeah.
I remembered as soon as I saw one of the killers, remembered one of them.
Yeah.
Which
one?
The woman.
Spoilers.
The woman.
Right.
But no, like, they're just like quite light-hearted films, even though they're not scary at all.
No.
But they're all right to shove on and watch. They are ones that, you know, again, it's the old, they come on after Graham Norton sort of thing.
Yeah.
So you'd sit up and watch it. I tell you what I hate, though. I can't stand her character.
Nick Campbell.
Yeah. Sydney, she's just annoying. And by the end of the second one, probably midway through, I was kind of hoping they would kill her.
But the thing is,
she's annoying.
She isn't the usual damsel in distress. She's not the same
as... She's pretty pathetic. Like.
But she's not the same as the 80s slasher movie damsels, is she?
Mm.
And that's the whole point of... or is she? You know what? I don't know. I'm going to have to rethink that.
She just annoys me. She's pathetic. She always like suspects a boyfriend.
Yeah, she's easily swayed, isn't she?
Yeah, you would have trust issues, I suppose, but it's very repetitive from the first one. You've got all the same characters in it. I didn't realise Pacey out of Dawson's Creek was in it. He wasn't in it for long, was he?
No, so yeah, he disappeared.
It's been up and rising.
What, 97?
Yeah. Oh. It's alright. It's easy watching.
Yeah,
you don't need a lot of brain cells to follow the storyline.
What I like about it is the fact that they lean on the sequel tropes and all that sort of stuff. Yeah, it's going to be bigger and better.
Yeah, they're setting up a third one, aren't they?
Yeah, they're setting up. It's good. Like it says, it's about franchises.
Yeah, and you notice the Freddy Krueger style jump.
Yeah, again,
because it's Wes Craven.
Yeah.
There's all these little nods in there to his other film.
Yeah, it is good.
Is it Jamie Kennedy that kill off early?
Jamie Kennedy is, I can't remember what his name is. Yeah, they kill him off. Mm. He's the one who has all the film knowledge and
he's the first one who's saying behind you,
and it's happening behind him. It's good.
It's an alright film. They're easy watching, aren't they?
Yeah.
They're not amazing, they're not scary, but...
I have seen the third one, because it comes back, Jamie Kennedy, in video form, to set out the rules of the trilogy. It's well thought out horror films, like, evaluation of horror films, or slasher movies, and it's just a clever next step. But I did enjoy it. I thought it was quite good, and just the amount of people who were in it, like guy from Sliders, what's he called? I can't remember what it was called.
Fat kid at Stand By Me.
Yeah, Oh, that's really crap. I can't remember. And who else, isn't it? The guy from Exorcist, David Warner, who I've met. That's a brilliant. Yeah, he's in it.
Yeah, I'm gonna give it 3 out of 5.
I'm gonna go 4 pumpkins. I was trying to preempt you. Yeah, 4 pumpkins for me. I enjoyed it tonight. That was really, really good.
Yeah, it's good. It's just a typical horror film, but taking the mess out of itself, isn't it? It's very light-hearted, and like you said, it's a bit of a different take on scary movies and the slasher movie. All I could think about though when Jada Pinkett Smith was in the movie theater was a scary movie where she's like, "Shut up, bitch!" and all that, like typical. I found it hard to differentiate between what happened in scary movie and actually what happens in Scream.
It's like because like the Scream 2 goes, it has a film within a film, and then like scary movies. Is almost like a separate entity that is outside that realm, but they've made it quite well, haven't they? Because I've pointed out too, it's like it's the second film with Jada Pinkett in this Halloween countdown.
What else was she
in? She was on the first one. She was on Creepshow. Tales from the Crypt.
Oh yeah.
Demon Knight.
Yeah.
But yeah, no, I'm really happy with tonight. It was real good.
It was a bit of a better one than some of the ones I've watched recently.
I can't remember what tomorrow is. Something or other. I think it's another sequel.
I can't remember, so I'll be fine. Right. Whatever comes up.
Yeah. Alright, well, you can find us on Instagram, WordPress, Facebook at The Ultimate Movie Geek, and subscribe to the YouTube channel. And you can also find me on worldgeeklynews.com. Share the videos. Get us out there. Thanks for watching. Sleep tight!